Get ready to match the stars. Dick Smothers. Brett Summers. Charles Nelson Reilly. From Hee Haw, Minnie Pearl. Richard Dawson. And Fannie Flagg and friend Joyce Bulifant as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 77. And now here's the star of Match Game 77, Gene Rayner.
What's going on? Thank you, Johnny Olson and friends, for joining us.
Well, well, we got a new kid on the block, haven't we?
Oh, watch it.
Well, you know, we have a little tradition here. We have to give you a proper welcome.
What are you going to do?
Nothing. Nothing too fancy.
You are going to kiss me, aren't you?
Now, you can't be laughing when I do this.
Because we bump teeth.
That's right, we bump teeth.
You got to pucker up now.
Aww. Oh,
welcome, Minnie Pearl.
What the heck was going on over here? I didn't see your face. I was standing backstage. I saw them on. Who was that?
That was Joyce Bulifant trying to get my job, but I've killed her.
She's on next week. She got all mixed up here. All right. Well, welcome back, Dickie boy.
Thank you very much.
Nice to see you again. Everything okay?
Everything's just great.
Grand.
What? Don't say hello to Charles and me. We don't
give
a...
for 4 years. For 4 years, no one has said hello to us. And it doesn't show so much on me, but look at her. It's too late now. 4 years, we don't even get a hello.
Well, that's better.
You didn't even get the mouse break.
We don't have a brother. We don't have a $1.98 hat. We don't have an accent.
Joyce, it's next week. Let me have my microphone table. Yes. Next week, Joyce. How many times do I have to tell you? Now let's walk.
I don't have anything to do today.
Well, go to my dressing room and wait for me there. Let's say hello to Barbara Hawkins and Diana Wells. Our current champion is Barbara Hawkins, who's won $1,800. Does that make you happy, Barbara?
Delirious.
Good. And she's going to be challenged by Diana Wells, who's had her first round question, right?
Yes.
The first ones are difficult, aren't they?
Well, I sure hope I do better next time.
Well, we'll see how you do. Now, we'll begin with her question, and then we'll get back to you. But first, we've got to get this to you. We are ready now. Here we go. The other round one question. Barbara, this is yours. Everyone will play. Here we go. At the Saudi Arabian restaurant, Harry said, "They serve the world's largest bowl of soup here. When they bring it to your table, there isn't a hair in it. There's a blank in it." When they bring it to your table, there isn't a hair in it.
Arabia.
There's a blank in it. At the Saudi Arabian restaurant.
I used to eat a Saudi restaurant.
You did? Really?
Very good food.
Good food.
Sort of oily.
Never had that. Olive oil. They use a lot of olive oil.
Oil. Real oil.
Oh, real oil.
Never mind. You just flew in?
Oh, I forgot. No, the jet lag's all gone already. Okay. Are you haven't got it together?
No, I have a hole in my pocket and I keep losing.
You keep losing things.
I keep losing my parking meter money.
I have someone who can sew that up for you. Yes.
Who is that person who can sew that up?
Well,
for?
Someone here like Dick Manderson. Anytime you're ready, Charles.
You
we're just killing time here while you're thinking.
I'm finished. I've been finished for an hour and a half. Look at him.
You want to say something to Brett?
Yes.
Okay, what do you want to say?
My husband and I were out in Encino this morning, but we couldn't find a motel.
Brett will help you.
Don't tell her the name.
No. At the Saudi Arabian restaurant, Harry said they serve the world's largest bowl of soup here. When they bring it to your table, there isn't a hair in it. There's a blank in it.
A camel.
A camel. That's okay. I'll read it one more time. At the Saudi Arabian restaurant. What do you say to that?
I say that there's a whole camel.
A camel. There you go, Roger.
Well, I thought they were famous for something. I said there was an oil well in it.
An oil well? All right. Now, Charles probably will come up with the definitive answer.
Sure.
See, when they bring it to your table, there isn't a hair in it. There's a blank in it.
Get this.
Oil well.
Oil well. Charles failed me. All right. When they bring it to your table, there isn't a hair in it. There's a blank in it, Minnie.
What it's a wig.
A wig! You got the idea! You got the idea right off the bat. Very good. Very good. You got the idea. You're going to be okay.
Oh, you're cute. Me for you, kid, when the lights go out.
Okay. Now, what do you say to this, Richard?
Well, read it.
One more time.
Hey, I did a little play on words.
At the Saudi Arabian restaurant, Harry said they serve the world's largest bowl of soup here. When they bring it to your table, there isn't a hair in it. There's a...
harem.
Harem! A lot of goodies on this one, aren't there? Yeah, so
yes.
You coming up with another goodie?
Well, I was thinking it was a rather large bowl of soup, and I live in Santa Barbara, and I thought of oil slick.
Oil slick. You've endeared yourself to your neighbors.
Absolutely.
The
I suspect I'll be moving back.
Okay, so there we are at the end of round one, and the score is 1-0 in favor of the current champion, and now we go to round two. This is the final round, Diana. This is where you said you're going to do better.
And I'm going to try that A again.
You're going to try A again?
Yes.
All right, here it is. Rodney is so rich. He's so rich, after he drinks a case of beer, he pays a man to blank.
Perfect.
All right. Well, that didn't take you long, did it? Got one? Okay. Now, Diana, Rodney is so rich, after he drinks a case of beer, he pays a man to blank.
How about tinkle for him?
How about tinkle for him? Okay. What do you say to this, Dickie boy?
Well, I think before he does that, he would have the guy burp him.
Burp him, right. That's the. Those are the two good answers, tinkle and burp. And what do you say?
Pardon me. Burp.
Or belch. Burp
I'm
or
sorry.
Belch, yep. Chuck?
Always the image of young mother. Burp.
Burp it is. So, Diana, you got three of those so far. You thought of that one, too? Was that your first idea?
Well, my husband does the other one more.
Oh. I see. What do you say to this, Minnie Pearl?
Burp.
You got four of those so far. And you? Burp. Five burps. And hello, darling.
You know, I love Minnie Pearl.
Yes, you do.
Oh. I wore this. It says
in your honor?
In her honor.
In her honor.
Now, you know, you may ask where I got this answer. There was an old dance team called Tinkle and Burp.
Tinkle and Burp. So at this moment, the score is tied. Barbara will have a chance to untie the score and win the game right after we do this for you. Here we go. You know what you have to do, Barbara?
Yes, I do.
What?
Two.
No, one.
Two?
Because you got one. You see, score's tied right now. One to win is all she has to do. Dick, you lay out this time because you matched her in the first round. Hey, did you hear about the New York City traffic cop?
No.
Want to hear about him?
Yeah. Sure.
When he lost his whistle, he stood in the middle of Broadway blowing his blank. New York City traffic cop. When he lost his whistle, he stood in the middle of Broadway blowing his blank. All right, here we go. Barbara, this New York City traffic cop, when he lost his whistle, he stood in the middle of Broadway blowing his...
nose.
Nose? One nose will win the game.
One nose.
There it is. That wins the game. What the rest of you have? Diana Wells, we admire you for the kind of work you do with young people.
Thank
and we've
you.
Got many gifts for you that'll be coming your way, and thank you for being with us in Match Game.
Thank you, I had fun.
Good, goodbye. Now, Barbara Hawkins is up here for the third time. Third time.
How do you feel?
I don't know yet. I have to go to the bathroom.
What?
Can I say that?
Sure. No, you can't say you have to go to the bathroom. No, that's not allowed there. I'll tell you, just let's not think about it or talk about it because it's 8 minutes before the next commercial and we don't... So here we go, Barbara. We polled a studio audience not too long ago and we said, write down your best answer to this.
Joan Blank. Now, if you match the answer they gave us most frequently, you get $500. If you match the second most popular answer, you get $250. And then you get $100 for matching the third. And let's see who will give you some help here.
Richard.
Joan of Arc.
Joan of Arc is one.
Charles.
Charles.
Joan Baez.
Joan Baez. You got two now. And Brett.
What about Joan Rivers?
Yeah. What's that? Oh,
Smothers. How about Joan Crawford?
How about Joan Crawford? Mind like a steel...
sieve.
So it's Joan Crawford, Joan Baez, and Joan of Arc. Barbara, you may choose one of those or reject all of them and give us one of your own. What is your pleasure here?
Joan Crawford.
Joan Crawford. All right, that's one that Brett gave you via Fannie. Here we go. What? My mic is breaking up. All right, I'll be very careful.
So is
there
mine.
It is. I'll just hold it here very carefully, and we'll replace it during the next commercial. I will hardly move it at all. I was wondering where that noise was coming from. Thank you for pointing that out to me. Now let's begin at the bottom, and we will reveal the $100 response. Joan Rivers is up there. Do not move because the mic will make a funny noise. All right, here we go. May we see the $250 response? Joan Crawford. So that means, well, before we get to that, what do you think's on the big one there? Joan of Arc.
Joan of Arc.
Arc, Arc, Arc. I thought there were a bunch of seals in the audience. Arc. Show us your Arc, Arc, Arc. Go ahead. Joan of Arc is right. Okay. Bobby, you picked up an additional $250. You now have $2,150. You're going to play for 10 times that amount, or... $2,500. That'll just about double your money there.
Oh, yeah.
And we'll be glad to give you that amount if you will match one celebrity exactly. Whom do you call on?
Do I have to turn like you?
No.
Richard.
Okay, Richard. All right, you face me if you would, please. Here we go. Sorry. Here it is. It's worth... Whoops.
You're in trouble.
I may get electrocuted before the show's over. You'll be a witness. We'll all sue CBS together. Here it is. Good luck to you. Blank turn. T-U-R-N. Blank turn. Blank turn. Now, Barbara, give us the answer that Richard has written on the card. We give you $2,500. What do you say to this? Blank turn.
Right.
Right turn. That was your first thought.
No, it wasn't.
It was not your first thought?
My first was U-turn. Well,
your first thought was U-turn, and you rejected that for right turn. Okay, let's turn to the left and find out what Richard has written on the card.
That's what I was hoping she was going to do.
What?
Turn to the left.
Turn to the left. You know, that was really an arbitrary one. I mean, kind of a difficult
one. Left turn, right turn, no right turn, no left turn, right in the middle. Good turn.
Good turn is another
bad
good
turn.
One. A lot of good ones there. All right, Barbara, you're up to 21.50. You're going to meet another player. Here comes Nikki Isley. Barbara, would you stand by for a minute?
I was supposed to do the show today, and I want to do it today, and there she is.
You get out of the set.
Well, I don't know how we can resolve this. Would you like to alternate with her, perhaps, on
other... No, I think I'll get more money on this side than on that side.
No, you won't. I'm not giving you any money now.
I got to go upstairs and do a show.
What show are you doing?
Three's Company.
Oh. Oh, we'll come up and watch a little bit later.
Okay.
And we're going to see you next week. Joyce Bulifant, ladies and gentlemen. All right. You have a seat, Barbara, and you want to do the commercial now? You don't want to recognize his presence at all. All right, you think about it for a second, Mickey. We'll do a little bit of business with America, and then you'll tell us the story of your life, okay? Here we go. Now, what do you say we all briskly applaud our new player here, Mickey Eisley. Yay, Mickey. How are you? Mickey, we'd like to find out a little bit about you before we start the game. What would you like to tell us?
Well, I'm 70 years old, a retired supervisor from the world's largest steel mill at Gary, Indiana.
No kidding.
And I married the prettiest girl in high school way back 52 years ago, still married to her. We have three sons, two of whom live in California. The other son and I came out for our granddaughter's wedding. How about that?
How about that? You're a grandfather, eh?
I'm a grandfather, yeah. Nine grandchildren, yes.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Now, are you living here now?
No, we're out here for a visit.
Oh, yeah.
I still live in Gary, Indiana.
Still live in Gary, Indiana. Gary, Indiana.
Go ahead.
You know that? It's as far as I go, Mickey. Well, it's a pleasure to meet you and have you here with us, sir. Here's our first round question. Mickey, you may have A or B.
I shall have A.
You shall have A.
A.
Did you meet your, you married your high school sweetheart?
Yeah, I married the prettiest girl in high school.
Well, now I have to dispute that, because I married a girl from Gary, Indiana.
But then,
Horace Mann High School.
Well, that was after my time. Mine was Emerson High School.
Oh, I see. Well, that's because I'm a lot older than you, Mickey.
Before Horace Mann was built yet.
Here we go. Paula said to her boyfriend, I have good news and bad news.
Uh-oh.
The good news is, everything I have is yours. The bad news is, I have blank. I like this one.
It's cute, isn't it? What famous football player comes from Gary, Indiana?
Tom Harmon.
Wrong.
Oh, yeah, Alex Karras, of course. Are you having a little difficulty, my friend?
Yes, I am.
Why, this is a wonderful, easy question. All right. Here we go. Mickey Eisley. Paula said to her boyfriend, I have good news and bad news. The good news is, everything I have is yours. The bad news is, I have blank.
The bad news is, I have, can I say?
Can you say what?
Social disease.
A social disease?
With Jesus. Can I help it if I'm bashful?
Mickey, you can say that, but I tell you, whisper it that way, and we won't tell the others what you've said.
Just whisper.
That's right. We'll just keep it
with
between the two
permission,
of us.
All
right.
Social
what
disease?
Is that official? His official answer?
That's his official answer.
Well, then mine is similar because nothing of value.
Nothing of value. That's a good one there. I got plenty of nothing.
And nothing's plenty for me.
Yes, Charles.
Get your glasses on, Brent.
I said nothing but the love in my heart and a bad back.
Nothing but the love in my heart and a bad back. Guy says, got good news, bad news. Good news is everything I have is yours. The bad news is I have...
Mumps.
Mumps. Well, I suppose it's contagious, but it's really not a social disease, is it? What do you say?
Bad news is I have the heartbreak of psoriasis.
Yes. I'm... What?
Can I say that on television?
Can you say what?
That on television.
Can you say that on television? Yes. A disease. Hard says... A disease, but what she meant was, they were really, you see, she was afraid to say it. Well, Mickey, nice try, old bean.
Don't cry, fam.
They're all watching back in Gary, Indiana.
Yeah, that's right, so.
Now, Mickey, you stand by. We're going to do a little business with America.